There was a great sage by the name Narsingh Mehta, and Narsingh Mehta was always singing the glories of Sri Krishna. He would sing several bhajans completely absorbed, but one particular raga he loved it. It was the Kedar Raga. One day there was a Brahmana who was very poor, and he wanted to get his daughter married. He did not have sufficient money. So he came to Narsingh Mehta and said, "Please help me get some money from this moneylender." So Narsingh Mehta went to the moneylender, requested the moneylender, "Please loan some amount so that he can conduct his daughter's marriage properly." The moneylender said, "What will be the mortgage?" So well, Narsingh Mehta said, "This Brahmana doesn't have anything to put mortgage." So the moneylender said, "Well, your Kedar Rag is very famous. Why don't you mortgage your Kedar Rag with me?" Which means that till the money is repaid, you cannot sing the Kedar Rag. Narsingh Mehta kept the Kedar Rag as mortgage, thinking that it's only a matter of time when this poor Brahmana will repay and I'll get the Kedar Rag freed. But unfortunately, the poor Brahmana just did not have the money to repay back, although the marriage went off very well. And so Narsingh Mehta was singing other bhajans, but still there was a vacuum in his heart because he could not sing his favorite bhajan through which he could really experience the presence of Sri Krishna. Sometime later, a group of wicked people gathered around and complained to the king that Narsingh Mehta is actually a hoax. He's a fraud. He's a charlatan, and he just keeps on singing bhajans to delude people and rip them off of their money. So the king became very upset, and they put a test for Narsingh Mehta where they had a deity of Krishna with garland in his hand, and Narsingh Mehta was asked to sing. And they said, "If Krishna does not walk and put the garland on your neck, then you are not really genuine." So Narsingh Mehta started singing, and he sang all the different bhajans he knew, but Krishna would not move. And Narsingh Mehta really wanted to sing the Kedar Rag, but he was bound by that contract of the mortgage. At that moment, as Narsingh Mehta's devotion swelled and his singing grew in pitch and tempo, there was a knock on the door of the moneylender. The moneylender opened the door, and lo and behold, he sees Narsingh Mehta standing there. And he says, "Here is the money. Please give me a receipt saying that you have freed the Kedar Rag." The moneylender got his money, gladly gave the receipt. At that moment, while the singing was going on, Narsingh Mehta opened his eyes. He saw Krishna's deity form, and then suddenly he saw on his lap a paper saying that the moneylender has released the Kedar Rag. Narsingh Mehta was in ecstasy, and he started singing the Kedar Rag. Krishna got influenced by his devotion, walked up to him and garlanded him. And thus the whole world could see that how Narsingh Mehta influenced the Lord by his love so much that the Lord personally went and repaid the debt so that the Kedar Rag could be released. Pariksha korite Gopal koila agyadan, Pariksha hoila sheshe hoila dayavan, ei bhakti bhakta priya Krishna vyavahar, bujhiteo amasabar nahi adhikar. The beautiful reciprocation between Krishna and his devotee, and the devotion between them, is extremely inconceivable. All we can do is simply hear about it, appreciate it, and have faith that Krishna responds to genuine devotion.